Hello and welcome. Next, I'd like to show you that how to replace this Toyota Corolla's thermostat. And this thermostat location is just in below of that electric this spark plug coil system, and it is just in here. And actually, it just in below of this coil system. And next I will show that how we can replace it. And this job is not the easiest one, and also it is not the most difficult. But this level is something like, if I have those four levels, and this is the most easiest one, like level one task. This is the level I estimate that level the third difficult level task, not this central finger, the level three, and the level four is the most difficult task. But I will learn that how to do that, and watch and learn is my motto. Okay, and this job starts so that I need to take this air filter console area away, that I can use that my tools in here, and then we continue that job. Okay, and then we need this 12 millimeter socket. What size was this? 1-2 millimeters, and then a little bit longer bar, and then this T-bar that I can rotate, or some other friends what switch well. And then in here we have one bolt in here what we need to open next. And let's look that third one, what is in it, is in here, in there. And then I saw that how to open those bolts, and when we use that T-bar, it is so easy that we need to actually, this is better example, that we need to only rotate that in this way. And this is so nice, this is like propel, plain slow moving propel, and then in there. And you might think that how much this T-bar cost. This is something like $5 to $10, this part. This is, and I recommend that if you do more repair things, then this is very nice and useful stuff. And then there opens, by the way, first bolt, and there is specific Toyota's bolts for air filter console. And if we need to purchase new one, we can get those in this Toyota dealership center. Now it seems that in here is my T-bar don't work so well, because there is this cable. This cable takes connection. And then important message. When we are working in here, don't mess with these electric spark plug cables, because this area, this is sensitive part. And if we hit and hammer that very much, then we have spark plug and sparking issues. And it's good to be careful. And that's, I change my tool. And now I have this, that kind of wrench that I can open. That. This is also quite useful. Like final bolt, and there was similar bolt as before. And now I believe that there is almost everything fine. And actually, there is one thing what I like to show. There is cable set what we need to open, and this is sometimes little bit tricky, and that's we need flathead screwdriver, And let's go to look what I mean. There is this cable set in here, that place. And next we need to open, actually take that cable set away, and I take a little bit better view that we can see that what I am meaning. Okay, and soon we continue. Okay, and then my thermostat replace work continues, so that I need to next disconnect couple of cables. And first cable what I need to disconnect is this thermostat temp meter sensors cable, and its location is there, and let's look that closer more. Okay, and there is this temp sensor cable, and it opens so that I press that central area down and then pull out. A little bit movement that way. And then we have in here upper one, we have those two cables in here, what are these spark proof cables, and then I press that central and then pull out this a little bit movement in that part. Do not pull in these wires because we can damage them. And then the second one is in there, and also press in here down and then carefully. And now these cables are fine, and I can move these cables away, all of these three in a little bit in that area. And then we have striped contact in here, and there is two nuts what I need to next open, and they are 10 millimeter socket, and soon I continue. Okay, and then we need this kind of tool. And especially this is this 10 millimeter socket what is in here, and it means that there is 10 millimeter is this sides, there is 10, and this socket it fits in here in that part, and now I can maybe use a little bit, I can use this longer bar. And I insert my socket in here, in that way. Then I insert that in there. And here is my friends in that position. Now we can see this thing. And then this opening happens that so that this opening direction is in that way. That I rotate that in this way. If I am right. Okay. Then important message. Now these thermostat cover nuts and bolts, they are aluminium. And aluminium is weak material if we compare to steel materials. And that's when we open these bolts, and especially when we fasten and tighten these bolts, we must be really carefully, because if we tighten those bolts too much, then those bolts goes broken. And I have experience of that. But it is not the fatal issue, because if those bolts goes broken, we can purchase new bolts in Toyota original dealership, and they cost something like $1 to $2 per piece, and we can survive, because Toyota's spare parts service works also in Texas and also in this area like this. What is this? Columbia in South America. Okay, and there is this, by the way, this bolt, and let's look that closer, because this is really specific bolt. This is aluminium bolt, and this is very weak, and that's we need to use a torque reference tool when we insert that back, because because this bolt goes broken really easily, and this is specific Toyota's aluminium bolt. And then also this part, the other part here, this is also aluminium, and that's we need to be very carefully. And then I open that, there is this lower bolt, it is in there, and it opens also. Okay, now actually my bar is too long, and I have to use shorter bar that I don't destroy this bolt. In that part, when we open and close this bolt, we must be very careful. But this tool must be in 90 degrees, this angle, that it is not in any bad direction. And now it's there, and then I open, cool, and it opens nicely. And then when we are now opening this thermostat cover, they'll start to grind out water, or actually coolant. And that means that we must have in waste canister now in below of this engine area, because this coolant liquid is harmful, and I have this canister in already in there, and because there is now grinding this water and coolant. Okay, but I continue. I take this lower bolt out, and now it's loosened, and I can use my fingers, and soon there is coming more of this coolant. And then remember that if you have hot engine, this coolant is very hot. But now my engine is not so hot. And there is similar bolt than before, aluminium bolt in there. Okay, and it looks like that. Okay, and then this my cover is free. And let's look in that area. And in this part is this temperature sensor. And then when I take my hands in here, and normally this opens quite easily, but if this is stuck, you can take like this small hammer and hammer that little bit in here, and then it opens nicely in that way. And there we can see the thermostat, and thermostat is easy to remove, that we take our hands in here and little bit movement, and there is this thermostat in here. Okay, and then when we look in here, we can see that what is this temperature meter, there is 82 Celsius. And I recommend that you purchase new thermostat in the nearest Toyota dealership center, because then we have high quality part in here. Okay, and this thermostat looks like that. Okay. And then we continue. Okay, and then when we are planning to install new thermostat, we need to check that there is no any corrosion in that inner area, and then also this outer area, what is in here, this outer area, it's in here, and when we look that, in here we can find corrosion, and let's look that closer. Okay, and I noticed that here is corrosion, and when I move that cover in here, this white thing in there, it is corrosion, and I need to clean that immediately, and for that we need sharp knife, and then carefully work so that you move that knife in out of your fingers in that way, not ever in this way, because then we have hurt and found bloody wound in here, and that's when we take this corrosion away. It happens in that way and also always out of your hand. And I take this away and also there, and that part that way and in here, and then this so that there is no any brass inside. And I saw that how to clean that next, and I have here fresh water, and I wash that stuff so that I insert there this stuff, and then only down everything goes out. Okay, good. And then it's of course good to be carefully when we work with these electric cables that there is no any wet in there, because if wet goes in these cables, then our engine don't start. Okay, and now I have washed that, and then we can start to install this thermostat back in this position in there. Okay, and then when we install this thermostat back, there is one thing what we need to remember, and this thing is that I take a little bit better view. The thing is that there is this small metallic part in their up area. Now we can see that part what I'm moving in here, and this must be in up when we install that in that thermostat in this hole. There is this hole, and then I take that my thing and I move that here carefully. I insert that in there inside. Okay, now when I press that, it looks good, and then we go to look that closer next. Okay, and then when you have installed the thermostat back, there is important to check that I have this knife, it's like my pointer, that this valve is like up. I think that this purpose is to release air if there is too much air, and then there is this gasket what must be in all areas nicely, like in here, in that step. Okay, and then when it's fine, we take this cover, and cover comes in here, and then we have these two special bolts, and now we have to be careful, because this is when we start to fasten these bolts. These bolts are very weak. It's like easy to damage, remember. And there is this outer bolt, and I first fasten those using my hands, and then I take this my 10 millimeter socket and this short bar, and then I fasten. And fastening rotation is that like clockwise. Then I fasten that lower bolt, and now I use my fingers. And now they are quite well in there, but then we need to do this final fastening. And in that step, I recommend that we use Torquay French tool, and this amount is something like 10 newton meters is this force. And then I take my Torquay French tool in here, and actually I carefully, because now I don't have this Torquay French, but it means that I use only little bit force. Only one hand, look. Only one hand. And then I take my grip in there short time. And when I take my grip in here, then this force is small. If I take in here, it is bigger force. And little bit down and then up. And carefully both of these. And it's it's good to be carefully. Now I think that they are fine, because there is risk that these bolts goes broken, and it's big job to replace. And then when these things are ready, we need to in final step, by the way, check that there is no any leaks in there. But normally when we tighten those quite well, not too much force, it's enough. And it's, if we have this torque reference tool, it's like 10 newton. Then I check that amount that I said, yes, it's newton meters. I have this torque reference, but now I have issue that this is so heavy caliper thing that this first level starts in 20. But we can, by the way, check that how this works. There's my socket, and I insert in here. Let's look at how this say click. Okay, now there is something like 10 to 20. Okay, this is good, it works. Now there is about 10 to 20 newton meters. And in LBF, there's LBF scale, it's like 450. 40, 30, less than something like 10 lbf. Okay, and now this cover is fine, and then I need to hook these cables. This is temperature setting cable, and when we press, we hear this click sound. It's Toyota's brand. Yes, click, it means that it's okay. And then there is those another cables, and this cable goes to this ignition coil set, and also listen this click, and there is also click. Okay, and this is fine, and now this thermostat job has been, it is ready, and final step is that I need to insert this air filter console back in there. Okay, and then when I have installed this thermostat cover back, I need to add in here this coolant. And coolant adding happens so that I open this cap, and then I need to add this coolant so much that this is full of coolant. And next I will show that. Okay, and here I have this coolant, and I add that radiator full of that. Okay, and I need more coolant. Okay, and now this radiator is full, and it's good thing. And then next step is that I need to start this car engine, and I need to check that there is no any leaks in any of these positions. And then I also close the radiator cap. Okay, and then I start engine, and I check that there is no any leaks in thermostat cover and thermostat array. Okay, and this was this thermostat replace, and thank you for watching that video.